They've done it. The Black Ferns won their sixth World Cup in style, making my Monday better than ever. I'm Grace, and here's the news you might have missed over the weekend. Pretty sure most of us were on our couches on the weekend or on the streets. Samoa beat England in the League World Cup semi, absolutely sending fans here. The All Blacks also beat Scotland in Edinburgh, but hey, at least the English took home the T20 Cricket World Cup. Business news, the government announced upgrades to ASEAN, the Australia-New Zealand Trade Agreement. It should make trading easier with our Indo-Pacific whānau, which is now our third biggest trade partner. An Iranian man who inspired Steven Spielberg's The Terminal has died in the airport that he once called home. Mehran Karimi Nasiri lived in Terminal 1 of Paris's Charles de Gaulle Airport for 18 years after he lost his residency papers. Rest in peace. Alec Baldwin has sued the crew members of the film Rust. That's for giving him a loaded gun which went off and killed the cinematographer last year. It's almost Christmas. Too soon? Well, some Kiwis are doing Christmas a little bit different this year. New survey says that we're planning a small celebration this time around, thanks to the cost of living crisis. Oh my god, don't even get me started with what's happening with Twitter. You probably know that paid verification is a thing now, thanks to Elon. Well, Twitterates are having the time of their lives, making fake accounts and tweeting. And Democrats have kept the Senate. It's good news for Joe Biden because the win helps him get his policies, cabinet appointments, and even judicial picks across the line. And finally, leaving you all with this amazing moment from Ruby Tui's Waiata sing-along. Ruby, you're a gem.